So far, you added a record button that is perfectly centered on screen on both an iPhone and an iPad. This is in the view of the ViewController.swift class. Now we need a way to connect the record button to the code in the ViewController. Since we need to work with both the view and the ViewController at the same time, we need a way to show them both simultaneously in Xcode. There's a great way to do this in Xcode called the Assistant Editor. To switch to it, first make sure that we've selected the main.storyboard file, as you can see here, and it's showing in the Content Editor. Then, click the Assistant Editor button here on the top right. It's the one that looks like two circles, intertwined. Then, make sure that we have the view controller selected here. Things are getting a bit crowded in our Xcode window. Let's close out the Inspectors window for now with the key shortcut Command-Option-0. Let's also hide the debug area for now by pressing the button here to hide it. We're going to use something called an IBAction to link the button to the view controller. It links the pressing of the button to a function inside the view controller. This is known as a target action. The target is the view controller, and the action is the function we're about to create. Select the record button. You can do it here in the document outline, and then holding down the control key, drag it over until it's right above the last curly brace inside the ViewController.swift file. Let go, and then from the dropdown, select Action. Let's give this action a name, such as Record Audio, and then click the Connect button. You can see Xcode has created a function for us called Record Audio, and has connected this button to this function in the ViewController class. We can see this function is connected because it has this filled-in circle here on the left side of the bar. This filled-in circle indicates that this is a special type of function called an IBAction that has a button or other UI element connected to it. Now, every time the user presses the record button, this function is going to get called. A good practice in software development is to test your code often. Our Pitch Perfect app is no exception. Let's add a line of what I like to call caveman debugging to this function to print out to the console that the button was pressed. Inside this function, let's add a print command so that we can just print out record button was pressed every time the user presses this button. Let's press the run button and test this app out. In my case, I've selected the iPhone 6S as a simulator to use. Now when I press the record button, I can see that record button pressed is showing in the console. Press it again, I can see that it's happening there. It's listing here on the right. Why do I call it caveman debugging? Well, it's the oldest and simplest form of debugging your code, just by logging something to the console. Later, in these courses, you're going to learn some really powerful ways to watch, debug, and step into the execution of your code. For now, we can be content with using caveman debugging to ensure that the record audio function is getting called.